Hi there, this is Tom Rickle from the AT&T Developer Program. Today, I'm going to give you a quick demonstration of how you can use Video Optimizer to set an artificial network attenuation at a specific bandwidth, and then attempt to play video at multiple resolutions and see what resolution successfully plays under that particular bandwidth. So I'm going to start by opening AT&T's Video Optimizer. And while I'm waiting for that to open, I'm going to tether my Android device, in this particular case, to the computer using a standard USB cable. Okay, let's go to the data collector and start a collection. We are going to turn on the attenuate slider. We're going to set a downlink attenuation by sliding, go to 1.5 megabits per second, use the left-right arrow keys to get to the exact value we want, and we're going to take a high-definition trace and give the trace folder a name. Now you'll see a window pop up on the left-hand side that shows you everything that's happening on the screen of my test device. For starters, we are going to just show you how that cap is working by opening the Ookla Speed Test app here, finding a server, and then running a speed test. This you normally wouldn't have to do. I'm just using this test as an opportunity to show you how the data cap is in fact in place. So Ookla has confirmed that our attenuation at 1.5 megabits per second is working as expected, so I will open our video playback app. For this demo, I will use YouTube because the Stats for Nerds feature will make it really easy for us to verify right on screen what resolution we're getting. Now I'm going to switch for a moment to the captured video, which is at a higher resolution than what you get in the thumbnail while you're taking a trace, and will be easier for you to read the Stats for Nerds on screen. Now you can see that the auto playback has chosen 360p resolution, so I'm going to try 480p and see if we can still get smooth playback at that resolution. Turning on the Stats for Nerds to verify that we are in fact playing at 480p, and it does look like smooth playback at this resolution. So now I'm going to try to bump it up to 720p and see if we have smooth playback at that resolution. And there's a stall. And there's another stall. So we're not really getting smooth playback at 720p, so I'm going to bump it back down and validate our 480p playback was smooth one last time. There's a brief stall there right when we switch from 720 to 480. I'm more interested in whether it stalls once we're at 480. And it looks like things are smooth at 480, so we can indicate that for this particular video, 480p does play back smoothly with a 1.5 megabit per second attenuation in place on the network bandwidth. So with that, we can stop our video, we can stop our trace, thank you for watching, and feel free to contact us if you have any additional questions about working with Video Optimizer.